Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you radiation intensity of antenna. This topic is quite interesting, and based on radiation intensity, you can understand many interesting concepts of antenna. I'll explain you each and every concepts in great detail. Let me define first what is radiation intensity. See, radiation intensity is average power per unit solid angle. So if you have average power and if you divide it by unit solid angle, then you will be having radiation intensity. Let me note it down. So radiation intensity U, that can be calculated as per average power radiated by antenna per unit solid angle. Now see, average power, that I have explained in my last video. So first I'll be explaining you what is unit solid angle. To explain unit solid angle, here we have antenna and that is radiating EM wave in the space, right? So here this antenna is radiating EM waves in the space. Now, but obviously, see, nearer to antenna, intensity will be higher, and as you move far from the antenna, intensity will decrease, right? Let us assume we want to calculate intensity at this location, and this location that is having distance small r from the antenna, right? So here, how to identify radiation intensity? Average power at this point divided by unit solid angle. So how to identify unit solid angle? See, to calculate unit solid angle, you need to have cross-sectional area at this location. If I say area at this location is A, then solid angle over here, that will be this area divided by square of the distance, right? So solid angle is three-dimensional angle, and that is been calculated in form of steradian. You see, radiation intensity unit, that is watt per steradian, where watt, that is a unit of power, and steradian, that is unit of solid angle, right? So solid angle is three-dimensional angle. Usually you calculate angle in terms of degree, that is two-dimensional angle. Solid angle is area divided by square of the distance, that is three-dimensional angle. Let me give one example. Like as if you have one projector and you are projecting that on screen. So but obviously on screen there will be area. That area divided by square of the distance of that projector will be solid angle of projector, right? So that is three-dimensional angle. So here radiation intensity, that is average power per solid angle, where solid angle is what? Area divided by square of the distance, right? So if you substitute that over here, then average power divided by area into R square, that is radiation intensity. Now see, here we have average power divided by area. So average power divided by area is average power density, right? See, this is average power density. Average power density is what? Average power divided by unit area, right? So if you substitute average power density in this, then you'll be having radiation intensity, that is average power density into square of the distance, right? In my last video, I have explained you average power density. See, average power density that we have calculated based on electric field and magnetic field. Based on electric field, average power density is E square by 2 eta, and direction is there in the direction of radial direction. What is radial direction? See, here this point, that is there in the direction of radial direction. So if you say this direction, so that is radial direction over here, right? So as if you talk about magnitude, then average power density in form of electric field is E square divided by 2 eta, and in form of magnetic field it will be eta h square by 2. Let me note it down. In form of electric field it is E square by 2 eta, and in form of magnetic field it is eta s square by 2, where this eta, that is free space impedance. See this eta, that is free space impedance, and its value is 377 ohm, right? To be precise, it is 120 pi. Approximated value is 377 ohm, that is free space impedance, right? And that can be calculated based on electric field and magnetic field that I have already explained in my last video. So here, see, average power density, that is E square by 2 eta, and it is also eta square by 2. If you substitute this in this, then you will be getting radiation intensity in form of electric field and magnetic field. So U will be this E square into R square divided by 2 eta in form of electric field, and U will be eta h square into R square divided by 2 in form of magnetic field, right? So that is how we can calculate radiation intensity. Now see, sometimes there can be question based on calculation of average power based on intensity, right? Like you see, in my last video, I have explained you average power calculation based on average power density. So average power is surface integration of average power density, right? Similarly, we can calculate average power based on radiation intensity. Let me explain you how. See, average power that I have explained in my last video, that is surface integration of average power density, right? And as if you want to calculate average power based on radiation intensity, then that is solid angle integration of radiation intensity, right? So here you see we have radiation intensity, and if you integrate it with respect to solid angle, then you will be having average power, right? Now we already know how to have this surface integration. Surface integration based on Cartesian coordinate, based on cylindrical coordinate, and based on spherical coordinate, we can easily calculate. But how to identify that with respect to solid angle? Let me explain you that. See, here, this solid angle integration that will be happening based on theta and phi, where, see, this solid angle is sine theta, d phi. So if you have variation of theta and phi, then you can integrate it as per theta varies from angle one limit to another limit, phi varies from angle one limit to another limit, and you will have to integrate this radiation intensity with respect to sine theta, d phi. That is how you need to do integration, and you will be having average power, right? So that is how basic calculation is there. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.